Frau Nexer, wir freuen uns auf Ihren Beitrag.
Dankeschön. Also ich darf heute meinen Kollegen Michael Hofstetter vertreten, der leider verhindert ist, um diesen Vortrag zu halten. Ich darf Ihnen die Ergebnisse aus dem Forschungsvorhaben WETRAX näher bringen. Das war ein deutsch-österreichisches Forschungsvorhaben, initiiert von der deutsch-österreichischen Ständigen Gewässerkommission. Als Einleitung möchte ich Ihnen die Grundhypothese näher bringen, dass großflächige Starkniederschlagsereignisse mit bestimmten Mustern in der großräumigen atmosphärischen Zirkulation in Zusammenhang zu bringen sind.
In a certain pattern in the atmospheric circulation. On the left hand side you see four different circulation patterns that led to heavy precipitation events in the past. So this example is for the area around Donau and up to Vienna. So there was a Mediterranean area, and so it led to heavy precipitation events and floods for the Donau River. In these years there were also big floods at the River Elbe in 2013 and 2002, and a different event was in 1997 at the Oder. There were also big floods. And now about the methods of this project. The methodical approach is parallel. At Vienna, we investigated tracks by means of a new method, and Professor Jakobait investigated circulation patterns and classified them, and he found out 18 different circulation patterns. With this tracking method, we investigated 10 tracks, which are important for Western Europe, and our area for investigation is this zone. What you can see here is an idealized 5B track, and at the bottom you can see the zonal circulation pattern that was generated by the University of Augsburg. So the data, reanalysis data, the input parameters were air pressure, humidity and lifting, and the different tracks and the different circulation patterns. So this is the data set for precipitation, which was generated new for this research. There was also already a data set for precipitation, but it was not covering the whole investigation area, and so it was necessary to produce a new precipitation data set. It covers now Germany, parts of Switzerland, Austria and the Czech Republic. The University of Augsburg processed this data set further, and they divided it into regions for precipitation with similar characteristics. So this is for the whole year. We have 8 different precipitation regions, and in this area it will be the Erzgebirge region and the eastern region. We have a catalog of different tracks, we have a catalog of different circulation patterns, and we divided it up for the different precipitation regions. The distribution of precipitation shows many differences for the different seasons. And so we have for the different seasons 6 to 8 different precipitation regions. And for the analysis of the past, we used the data of the precipitation data. and classify them to the different tracks to see which tracks are relevant for precipitation, and the same also for the circulation patterns. And so in the result, we used three climate models, and we investigated historic runs to see how well the climate models can show what happened in the past and how they coincide with the analysis data. And so the lower RCB 4.5 and the stronger is 8.5. We investigate them to see how the tracks develop compared to the reference time period between 1981 and 2000, and how it will change in the future. Now some results from the track catalog. You can see 8 tracks here. The abbreviations refer to the area where the track starts and where the track comes from. So this is the Atlantic track.
Zum Beispiel abgetropfte Höhentiefsysteme oder Tiefdrucksysteme, die in unserer Untersuchungsregion stehen.
Low pressure system, was sofort ins Auge springt, ist, dass
diese beiden Zugbahnen bereits 50% der über Europa Zugbahnen
make up for 50%
wesentlich wichtigere the detected tracks over Europe,
and the important track 5B is only included in 5% of the whole number of tracks. On the right hand side, on the top, you can see the number of
the mean number of frequency of the tracks per year, and
about double of the tracks are detected at the ground than in the height, and that's because of orography. In the height there are less disturbances, and that's why there are less low pressure systems.
Auf die Niederschlagsanalyse, die
so this was the precipitation analysis, so you can see the charts here, which tracks are responsible for the top 20 precipitation events between 1961 and 2002. When we concentrate on the northern regions, especially 5B is responsible for 25% of the top 20 events. And when we look at the region of the Northern Czech Republic, it's even more. So we could prove that 5B is especially important for the middle of Europe, for the whole investigation area. Is this the most interesting track? And we have to investigate it much more. And so we decided for this project to look at all tracks and investigate all tracks, but especially 5B.
Jetzt hat sich natürlich die Frage gestellt,
and now the question was about the past, if there were already trends for the 5B track. So could there be increases, decreases detected? And we have to answer this question with no. What we also investigated are seasonal changes. Are there seasonal changes?
Regarding,
is there a certain cycle in the 5B tracks? And what we found out is in winter time, 5B low pressure systems are more pronounced. They have a lower core pressure than in summer, but the summer events are responsible for more precipitation amount over whole bigger areas. So we have to have a closer look at the summer events. So in the past there was no trend for the 5B tracks, but now the question is how it is in the future. So in the future there will be a decrease in general of the low pressure systems at ground level and also at height level, so of about minus 15%. So in the farther future, between 2071 and 2100, the low pressure systems will decrease. And what about the precipitation? So this was, we tried to summarize the results for all tracks together for the interesting regions, or mountains, eastern part and the northern part of Czech Republic. On a seasonal basis, you can see the amount of precipitation, and on the right-hand side, you see the threshold values from the historic runs of the climate models. So in this chart, I decided for the model ECHEM 6, because we have the most of the data for this model, and so the conclusion will be more robust. So we see all the runs that were available, and when we look at the whole year and all tracks in general, then we see an increase of the amount of precipitation. But how can we explain this when the tracks in general decrease? So we are at a different temperature level, it will be warmer, and that's why the air can take up more water vapor and more humidity. And when there are such precipitation events, of course, there will be more amount of precipitation. And the summer is very pronounced, where we can see a decrease of the amount of precipitation between 10% and 30%, depending on the region. So this is the investigation of all tracks in general. But when we look at the 5B tracks only, then we can see a contrary picture for the summer month. In the summer month, we will have an increase of the precipitation amount by 5B tracks, although the number of tracks gets smaller. So this was the result from the first investigation run. And now about the circulation types. The University of Augsburg classified the circulation types, and they used the SATRA method, and they grouped it up in 18 classes. Conditions means the precipitation was also used for classifying the different patterns. And they developed a model in order to model the precipitation for the future. I want to show you two circulation types which show up in spring and in summer, especially in the area of the Ore Mountains, eastern Germany, and northern Czech Republic, and which are responsible for heavy precipitation there. So in spring, it's circulation type 1, so that's a low pressure area on the ground, and humid and warm air. So we have pressures of 700 hectopascals, a very much vertical movement, and as a result, you see precipitation at the northern edge of the Alps in the Czech Republic and in the Ore Mountains. And so the regions change for the different seasons. And in this season, we don't have Ore Mountains, East and Northern Czech, but it's we have a similar precipitation in these areas. So in this table, you can see all circulation types that were detected by the University of Augsburg and the different regions, precipitation regions, and what do the numbers mean in this table. So for circulation, this type, the number of 46% means as soon as this circulation type 16 occurs, in 46% of all cases there will be heavy precipitation events in the Ore Mountain region. And in the eastern region it will be even stronger, 80%. So in 80% of the days where we have this circulation type, there will be heavy precipitation precipitation events. And now we look at the future. On the x-axis, green, these are the circulation patterns with types which are relevant for precipitation. And you see the changes in frequency of occurrence of these circulation types in the future. So some circulation times increase, some decrease, some are significant and some are less significant. But this type 16 increases significantly, although in general we have to say that the heavy precipitation circulation types decrease, but in this case this special circulation type will increase.
Sowohl in der nahen als auch in der fernen Zukunft.
Also in the near future and also in the far future, in both scenarios.
Gehen wir jetzt weiter zum Sommer.
And when we continue with the summer, we have a different circulation type. This is circulation type 1.
Weist ein ähnliches Muster auf,
it's a similar pattern with low pressure on the ground in the middle of Europe, but a little bit more to the north and to the west. Then circulation type 16, also very strong vertical movements. And because of the change in the location, there is a lot of accumulation in the Ore Mountains and heavy precipitation events there. And how does this circulation type change in the future? But first of all, the same table that we looked at before for circulation type 16. And for circulation type 1, we can see that 90% of all days where it occurs, there will be heavy precipitation events in the Ore Mountains and 63% in the northern part of Czech Republic. So as soon as this circulation type occurs,
there
can be heavy extreme precipitation events in these areas, and so this could be also a cause for floods. And how does this circulation type change in the future? You see the circulation types that are significant for the summer and the change signals. You can see that circulation type 2 decreases and is significant, but circulation type 1 increases, but not significantly.
Jetzt haben wir zwei
and now we have two ways for conclusions and how do they coincide. So when we look at the near future, all boxes which are red or blue mean they show that these two methods coincide, and when you have gray color, so it means there is a contrary sign.
Für die nahe Zukunft ist, dass
so what we can see in the near future, we see an increase of the heavy precipitation amount,
gehen wir in die ferne
independent
Zukunft,
of the seasons and the year.
Wird es mit dem
but
Herbst
when we look in the far future, with the autumn it gets more difficult.
Unterschiedliche Vorzeichen.
So we have different signs there,
but
for summer they coincide completely and we see a decrease of heavy precipitation events.
So, nun zur Conclusion.
And now about the conclusion.
Für das Projekt Vetrax,
for this project Vetrax, we generated a new data set for precipitation, and so it was a cross-border precipitation data set, and we found regions which are similar in their precipitation variability, and so there are 6 to 8 different regions formed, and we found circulation types and tracks which are especially relevant for heavy precipitation events.
So
for summer, it's meridional,
low
pressure troughs, over Middle Europe with a low pressure at the Alp region.
Eine hohe Relevanz
and especially in summer, they are very relevant for heavy precipitation. In winter, these circulation types and patterns are totally different. Tracks that come from the Atlantic to Middle Europe.
Wie schon vorher erwähnt, wie sieht das in der Zukunft aus?
And how it will be look like in the future? In wintertime, you see an increase of the zonal circulation patterns,
für den Sommer
but in summertime, it will stay the same or the circulation types for heavy precipitation will decrease. There is a big discrepancy between the three different climate models that we use. In general, there will be a significant decrease of the frequency of tracks over Middle Europe, so minus 15%. But regarding the heavy precipitation amount and the frequency of these occurrences is different. So we have an increase in spring between 5% and 15%, especially in the northern regions. And in summer until 2050, there will be an increase of the precipitation amount, but in the far future, there will be a decrease of minus 5 to minus 30 degrees. So this is contrary to the results for the 5B tracks, because there it shows an increase for 10 to 25%. Thank you for listening, and the final report for this project you can find also on the internet.
Ganz herzlichen Dank, Frau Lexer.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Lexer, for this nice presentation and interesting lecture. So there are already the first questions.
Ja, mein Name ist Kondor aus der Stadt Dresden. Ich bin auch zuständig für die Hochwasservorsorge.
And I'm responsible there for the flood risk management. And so I'm a little bit worried about your conclusions. So when you modeled this, did you also the increase of the water temperature of the Mediterranean Sea? So this was not part of our investigation. There will be too much efforts, and for time reasons, we didn't include this. So could it be even worse than, so what we don't know is the uncertainty. But in the final report you find our uncertainty analysis. So of course there are always uncertainties. It could be it gets worse, it could be that it won't be as bad.
But
since we will have a higher temperature level, it's rather that it will increase, but how much it will increase, we cannot tell you this 100% sure. Falk Böttcher, German Weather Service, the circulation types that you classified and detected. Do you still do this now? Will you update this? So this would be a nice medium for the forecasters. So when there is 90% occurrence probability for circulation type 1, then they know that something happened. So in Vienna, we will use the tracks for the forecast, but as far as the University of Augsburg, if they still use the circulation types, I'm not sure about this. You would have to ask Professor Jacobite if it's possible to continue these circulation types and include this.
Ja, ich würde auch gerne noch
I would also like to ask for some details.
Sie haben einen neuen
so you've shown the new precipitation data set. So this is very interesting,
but
you didn't tell us what you used it from and what is the resolution and
so
a rough estimation. So where it comes from,
and you didn't tell us
which three climate models you used. So this would be also interesting for people who work with global climate models,
and especially the question
if the tracks change or are different.
Ja, also
because this would tell a lot about the characteristics of the tracks in the models.
So
this is really interesting and exciting.
And the next thing is,
so the University of Augsburg
with the
weather pattern classification developed a method for the future, but you didn't tell us how it works, if they also use global model results or how they do this in the future. So that's why I ask for these details. It would be nice if you could answer this. So the first question, the precipitation data set was used from results from Austrian stations. It has a resolution of 6 kilometers. It was further processed for the area of Austria, and there the resolution is 1 kilometer. The climate models that we used, maybe you've seen this in the table, for the analysis of the future. One of the models is HM6, RCB458, and historic runs 1-2-3 and future runs 1-2-3. The second model was HM5, scenario A1B, and the third one, but we only used runs 1 and 3 because there were problems in the second run. And the third one, at the third model, was IstiGraph, only one run, and we've seen that Easy Earth, for the surface low, it's very nice to see the past. And what was the third question? The circulation types and the future prediction.
Mit der konditionierten Sandra Methode ist
so this conditioned Sandra method, they generated a model which uses the input of the climate model data and it will generate future predictions. The same models again, yeah. And the important input parameters are the air pressure and the humidity. For the exact description, please ask the colleagues in Augsburg.
So 2 years ago,
there was a lecture of Professor Jakobait, and he already talked about some details. So in the abstracts, they are available on the internet, and also Professor Jakobait will answer your